I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Martin Luther King Jr., Rosa Parks, Thurgood Marshall. These are all names of African Americans you may be familiar with. They were very important in the fight for civil rights and the end of segregation. But in every fight, there are people in the background who organize, inspire, work on the details, train volunteers, and think of new ways to move their cause forward. Ella Baker is one of those people. Ella Jo Baker was born in Norfolk, Virginia in 1903. Listening to stories told by her grandmother, who had been an African American held in slavery, Ella developed a feeling for the injustice of segregation and racism. Her grandmother had been whipped for refusing to marry a man her owner had chosen for her. Ella attended Shaw University in Raleigh, North Carolina. She was a bright student and did well in school. Even in college, when she felt a school rule was unfair, she fought to change it. After graduation, she moved to New York City and began joining social change organizations. She was a social advocate. A social advocate is someone who sees unfairness in society and works to change the problem. Ella joined the Young Negroes Cooperative League, whose purpose was to strengthen African American economic power. She also joined women's organizations. She was dedicated to justice and equality for all people. Ella began her involvement with the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, or NAACP, in 1940. She traveled the southern United States promoting civil rights and inspiring African Americans to be strong in their fight for fair treatment. Ella believed in the power of the people to make change, that simple African American citizens have the ability to make great things happen if they work together. In North Carolina in 1960, after a group of black college students refused to leave a white-only lunch counter, Ella was inspired. She organized the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, or SNCC. Using the same idea that Mahatma Gandhi used in his fight for freedom, the students protested unfair treatment in nonviolent ways. Marches, protests, and activities like the Freedom Rides were organized by the SNCC. Because of her ability to lead and inspire, she was given the nickname Fundi, a Swahili word meaning a person who teaches a craft or skill to the next generation. Ella died in 1986 at the age of 83. Her work behind the scenes during the struggle for civil rights helped move the cause forward. Her actions changed the future for African Americans in the United States.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting cow.
Interrupting
cow. Moo.